How are y'all doing today on YouTube? I'm here to give you a video on how to take care, set up, and manage an ant farm. As you can see, I have a custom-made ant farm. I actually made it myself. It took me about a week and a half to make. And in it, I have harvester ants. Now, that is one of the most important things about making an ant farm, is you need to realize the kind of ants that you're going to be using and what they're capable of. Harvester ants can dig 15 feet nest into the ground. So I decided to use them for this particular ant farm because it's 5 feet tall. And I wanted some ants that could reach to the bottom fairly easy. And let's zoom in here. And as you can see, it took them about 4 days, 4 to 5 days, and they've already reached the bottom. Now, another reason why I chose harvester ants was because they are not very good climbers. And as you can see, you know, you don't see any of them climbing on the glass. And they're actually very poor climbers, they actually have trouble actually even climbing up small plants. So for this particular farm, I chose harvester ants because I think that was the best choice. I do not have a lid on this particular ant farm at all. No lid. I have no gel or no kind of Vaseline or anything at the top to prevent them from climbing out, because they frankly just, they cannot climb out. I mean, so that's one of the benefits of having harvester ants, especially if you have a glass tank. Now, I wouldn't use plexiglass or any kind of a plastic if you can make a custom ant farm for harvester ants without using a lid. A reason for that is because I think with plexiglass, they can scratch it a little bit, and over time, they can make little grooves in it where they might be able to climb out of it. But if you have any questions about the ant farm or how to make one this size or how to maintain or manage it, feel free to shoot me a question or email, and I'll definitely respond back, make a video on it for you, and letting you know, what I use, the techniques I use to, you know, manage an ant farm this size. And I definitely have no problem doing it, so just feel free to hit me up with any questions that anybody have out there. Because I actually had trouble finding some information about ant farms and how to build one this particular size, so I decided to do a video myself on it. If you're interested, I can also do a video on actually the materials and what you would need to make an ant farm this size. I think the total cost for this particular ant farm was around, I want to say a little under $200 for everything, sand, glass, the wood. So, you know, I think it turned out pretty well, especially if you enjoy ants and something you enjoy, you know, watching. See, they're so small. Now, for this particular ant farm, one of the things I want you to keep in mind is when you put the sand in your ant farm, be sure to add water to it. Now, some people like a sand and dirt combination, or sand and soil, rather. Place soil in with the sand, and that's not a bad idea. That's actually a fairly good idea to do that. Because what it's going to do is, it's going to give your tank or give the sand in the tunnels some strength. I have an all sand tank. I did not add soil in it, but the next tank that I do build, I will be adding soil and a combination of both. Sorry about the glare. It's daytime, the sun shining right through the window. See if we can zoom in here. You can actually see one in the tunnel carrying, I guess, some pieces of sand. Now, the best thing that I found for watering ants is actually just a spray bottle. I know a lot of people are into making self-sustained water sources for the ants. And, you know, with a farm this size, with a farm this size, I couldn't find a really good water source for these ants. I actually had some kind of like cups or water droppers in there, but they were actually drowning themselves inside these cups and these little water droppers that I had inside of here, and they're actually getting stuck inside of it for some reason. I guess they were playing follow the leader, and they all just, I opened it up and I had like 60 ants inside this particular cup. God, but the best thing I found for these ants is just a simple water bottle. Just spray it in at the top. That's what I do. And just spray along the edges of the top of the back of the glass. I wouldn't spray on the front of the glass because it'll make it dirty over a period of time. And it is hard to clean inside the ant farm because there's so it's such a tight and narrow space. So spray on the back of the glass. And it doesn't take much water. I give them water probably like once a day. That's all it really takes. And as you can see, they'll notice that the water's there on the glass, and you'll see them start to try to climb on the glass to get the droplets of water. And it's pretty effective. But if you have any more questions about ant farms and how to maintain an ant farm or set one up, like I said before, feel free to shoot me an email and I will answer or make a video on any questions that you have. And in this particular ant farm, one thing I did that I thought was pretty neat and interesting, which was I actually threw out the layers of the sand. There's actually rocks, sticks, and debris, just like you would see in nature. And as you can see, as they go down, they come in contact to rocks and sticks and leaves that I have inside the sand. And you can actually see a little bit of it through the tunnels. And as they dig more tunnels, you'll be able to see more of the debris show through.